Hello everyone, welcome to our 23rd lecture, and this lecture is based on arc interruption theories. Up till now we have seen arc interruption in circuit breaker. Okay. Now we'll switch over to arc interruption theories. The multifaceted behavior of arc in a circuit breaker at the time of short circuit has led to the invention of different arc interruption methods. Various theories have been suggested by many researchers for the fast and reliable treatment of arc interruption, and this includes high resistance and low resistance interruption theories. In high resistance method, the arc resistance is increased with time. This will reduce the current to such a value which will insufficient to maintain the arc, and thus current is interrupted and arc is extinguished. If you increase the resistance, the current will reduce, and that's why the arc get extinguished. This method is employed in only DC circuit. Okay. As DC have constant waveform, so this method is applicable for DC circuit. In this, the resistance of arc may be increased by different methods: lengthening the arc, pulling the arc, reducing the cross section of the arc, and splitting the arc. Now, what is this lengthening the arc? As you know, R is equal to rho L by A. That means resistance is directly proportional to length. Okay, so this is high resistance method, high resistance interruption method. So we have to increase the arc resistance. We have to increase so that the current flowing through that will reduce to minimum value. So it is done by lengthening the arc. R is equal to rho L by A. If you increase the length that arc, if you increase the length of that arc, resistance will increase and the arc get extinguished. Second is cooling the arc. Cooling the arc, it will deionize the medium. Then reducing the cross section of the arc, R is equal to rho L by A. If you reduce the cross section, that means if you decrease the area, cross section area, resistance will increase. So this is third method. And then splitting the arc. In splitting the arc, definitely resistance will, that arc column you have to split. If you split that arc column with the help of splitters, then resistance get increase. Now these methods are employed in air brake circuit breaker, air blast circuit breaker, that we'll see while studying the air brake circuit breaker or air blast circuit breakers. Okay, so we have high resistance method, and now we'll switch over to the low resistance interruption method. In this method, arc resistance is kept low until arc current becomes zero. Now this low resistance interruption method is applicable for AC circuit breakers. It, as high resistance is applicable for only DC, it can be applicable for AC also, but this low resistance interruption is applicable for AC circuit because the AC have alternating waveform. Okay, it passes zero. Okay, it passes zero means when current becomes zero, that means for a very few microsecond, or that arc is quenched. You can tell that arc is quenched for a second when arc current passes through the zero. It passes twice in a cycle. So this is called as a low resistance interruption method, and this is applicable only for AC circuit breakers. Now for this, again the researchers, there are many researchers who shown theories related to low resistance interruption method. Out of that, two theories are important, that is Slapian theories and Cossis theory. The Slapian theory is called as race theory, while Cossis theory is called as energy balance theory. Now we'll switch over to the Slapian theory. First theory, that is called as race theory. Here there is a race between dielectric and rate of rise of race striking voltage. The arc is a column of ionized gases. To extinguish the arc, the electrons and the ions are to be removed from the gap immediately after the current reaches to a natural zero. Ions and electrons can be removed either by recombining them into neutral molecules or by sweeping them away by inserting insulating medium, gas or liquid into the gap. Now you can see we have air circuit breaker, air blast circuit breakers, aseptic circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breaker. That means we are inserting that medium externally. Okay, so by inserting that medium, we are making the contact between that the medium between that two contacts deionized, so that restriking voltage is less and dielectric strength is more. The arc is interrupted if the ions are removed from the gap, recovers its dielectric strength as compared to the rate at which the restriking voltage, transient voltage across the gap rises. Okay, if the dielectric strength increases more rapidly than the restriking voltage, the arc is extinguished. If dielectric strength between that two contacts of the circuit breaker increases more rapidly than the restriking voltage, the arc gets extinguished. If the restriking voltage rises more rapidly than the dielectric strength, as different insulating medium have different dielectric strength, air have different dielectric strength, vacuum have different dielectric strength, aseptic gas have different dielectric strength. So if that restriking voltage rises more rapidly than the dielectric strength of the insulating medium, the ionization persists and the breakdown of the gap occurs, resulting in an arc for another half cycle. Now by this diagram you will get clear idea of dielectric strength and restriking voltage. At each current zero, there is a race between rate of rise of restriking voltage and the rate at which the insulating medium recovers its dielectric strength. If the rate at which dielectric strength progresses is faster than the rate at which voltage rises, the arc will quench. Otherwise, the arc restrikes and is not interrupted. Now, here you can see it is a graph between recovery voltage and time, recovery voltage and time. In this first graph, you can see this is dielectric voltage. This is dielectric voltage. This is on upper hand than the voltage recovery. That means this is your rate of rise of restriking voltage and this is your dielectric strength. If dielectric strength is greater than the restriking voltage, arc interruption occur or arc is interrupted. Now in second diagram, that is B diagram, you can see this is voltage recovery and this is dielectric recovery. Here dielectric strength, if you consider this portion up to this portion, here dielectric strength is more. Okay, in our first half, if dielectric strength is more, that means deionization is more. And at this point what happens? At this point, this rate of rise of restriking voltage due to many factors, that factors already you have seen in our last lecture. Due to that factor, if suppose rate of rise of restriking voltage is greater than the dielectric strength, then this have upper hand. This voltage recovery means rate of rise of restriking voltage have upper hand over this dielectric recovery. Now in this case, here ionization occurs. Here deionization of the medium, then after this point there is ionization of the medium. Now here arc will restrike. This is called as dielectric failure. This is your Slepian's theory. This theory is called as race theory because it is the race between rate of rise of restriking voltage and the rate at which dielectric buildup. This is rate at which dielectric buildup and this is rate of rise of restriking voltage. If rate at which dielectric buildup is more, the arc will quenched. Okay. Now we'll switch over to the next, that is Cassie's theory. It is also called as energy balance theory. The space between the contacts contains some ionized gas immediately after the current zero and hence it has a finite post-zero moment. Now in this moment, power is zero because restriking voltage is zero. When the arc is finally extinguished, the power gain becomes zero. The gap is fully deionized and its resistance is infinitely high. In between these two limits, first the power increases, reaches the maximum value and the decreases, and finitely reaches zero value as shown in figure. Now you can see here, there is power, this is time. At this point t is equal to zero, this power is increasing and that is reaches maximum, and this at r is equal to infinity, at this point arc is quenched and r is infinity, man means resistance is increased and here power is reduced, it is to zero. Okay, so as this Cassis explained that arc interruption theory is by it is energy balance, that is it is compared with the energy. We want to minimize that energy between that two contexts. If you are able to reduce that energy to the zero value, that arc will get quenched. If you are able to minimize energy means heat, if you are able to minimize that heat between that media, between that two circuit breaker contacts, then definitely arc will get quenched. It is from R0 to R infinity. Due to rise of restriking voltage and associated current, energy is generated in the space between the contacts. The energy appears in the form of heat. The circuit breaker is designed to remove this generated heat as early as possible by cooling the gap, giving the blast air or flow of oil at high velocity and pressure. If the rate of removal of heat is faster than the rate of heat generation, the arc is extinguished. If the rate of heat generation is more than the rate of heat dissipation, the space breaks down again, resulting in an arc for another half cycle. That means it is energy balance theory. You have to, if that heat you have to remove, that energy you have to remove, if you are able to minimize that heat, reduce that heat, the dielectric strength will be built up and the arc will get quenched. Okay, now this it is possible to extinguish or to minimize the heat by using cooling the gap, giving the blast of air, oil, SF6, that there are different insulating medium available for quenching the arc. Okay, same theory is explained. Okay, that means our aim is to quench the arc. Now Cassis theory, it is explained by this diagram. Here we have current and time. If the rate of heat dissipation between the contacts is greater than the rate at which heat is generated, the arc will get extinguished, otherwise it will restrike. That means that energy, that heat we have to remove. If heat dissipation is faster than the heat generation, the arc will get quenched, otherwise it will restrike. At current zero, the hot arc between the contacts of the circuit breaker need to be cooled down to such a low temperature that it no longer conducts. Now here you can see, this is arc conduction. Here arc is conducting. Now here, as arc conduction, here current get interrupted. Here dielectric build up, now it is going to zero, and this is your arc interruption. Now here arc interruption, here we want to minimize the heat generation. Now here, if it is going like this, it is going to zero, that means arc get interrupted. If it is not going to zero, heat generation is faster than the heat dissipation, then at this point arc will restrike. Okay, so this is current, arc current waveform. At point this, arc current will go to zero after circuit interruption. Okay, and here heat dissipation, if heat dissipation is faster, then it will go to zero. If not, arc will restrike. Establishment of thermal interruption with post current zero. This is our Cassis theory. It is also called as energy balance theory. Thank you.